2002 Subaru Impreza wagon, and it's not just a regular wagon.
It's a little more.
I have my buddy Migs right here. If you've seen, I believe it was the short shifter install on the Veloster, he was in it at the end. And he's coming with me so he can give you guys a full rundown of what this car is and how he built it, because he did most of it himself. And then I'm gonna be driving and enjoying the crap out of this thing. So give a full complete rundown of what you've done, engine wise.
Okay, well, I bought the engine mostly how it is. I did a few things, but it has the 257 short block with ACL black raised bearings, an 08 STI pan, oil pan, a baffle and a pickup and everything, APR head studs, EJ205 heads that were ported to a 2.5 to match the block, 05 STI cams, and then basically everything else is from the STI.
So it's a complete STI swap.
Yeah.
So this car would originally come with a 2.0 boxer engine, I believe. And do you know the power output of those, or?
It's in the 230s.
And then with the STI stock, what would it push out?
I think 280 something to the wheels.
Okay, so that's stock.
Yeah.
Okay. God.
It's a whole different experience in the passenger seat.
God, I can't believe you trust me driving this car.
Might as well.
So, if you guys know anything about STIs, those things are stupid expensive, even older models. So, I believe like an 05 still goes for like 16 up.
Yeah.
Which is crazy, because if you get the normal one, how much would a regular Impreza from like that year be?
From like an 05, you could find them for less than 10.
Okay, so it's twice as much.
Yeah.
Just for an STI.
Yeah, definitely.
Now, is it cheaper to swap everything or just buy the actual STI?
I still spent less with everything converted. It's just a hell of a lot of work.
Yeah?
Like, yeah.
Well, I mean, if you have mechanical knowledge, then
yeah. I did everything on my own, and I pretty much learned on it.
So, like Mick said, he had owned the car with an STI swap engine already in the car. And how'd you blow your transmission?
In the canyons.
Damn, dude. What did you do? Like,
I was just hauling. I love going to the canyons. Oh man. I love going to the canyons. I'm always there. I've been there like 3 times this week alone. And I was out there just, you know, going the speed limit, and my 5-speed decided to blow up.
What gear did it give out in?
4th gear.
Shut the fuck up.
I shifted in the 4th and it was just crunching. It didn't even...
Really?
It didn't want to go in.
Yeah, 5-speeds, I mean, most that I know, can't really handle
They're trash, power. Especially on the Subarus, they're trash.
Because I know on the E46s, I heard that my transmission can only handle about like 260 torque. Or 270 around there, really? Which is pretty much nothing. So if I ever swapped it with anything, which went full bolt on, it's already like pushing that.
Yeah.
And I don't know if that's wheel torque or actual crank torque.
Yeah, these 5-speeds are only made to handle the stock power from the WRX, which is in the 230s, and I'm pushing over 300.
Yeah, way more.
So I was just waiting for it to blow out. I just didn't think it would be that soon.
So he ended up swapping the transmission with the STI. Transmission, and was that STI transmission from this car, from the wagon?
No, it was from an 02 JDM STI, so bug eye STI from Japan. Yeah.
And are the transmissions from Japan and the US different?
Yeah.
6-speed?
Yeah. Well, they didn't even make the STIs over here. Yeah.
And is the engine JDM as well?
No, it's USDM.
Okay.
But yeah, the whole drivetrain is JDM STI.
Even the interior looks all fucking sporty.
Yeah, this is like a limited package option to have the leather seats. Yeah,
and he has a Momo steering wheel, which I guess is factory.
Yeah.
Is it factory from this car or the STI?
No, the STIs have a different one.
Okay, so that's factory for this car, which is pretty dope because it doesn't even have the Subaru emblem. It just has the actual Momo one. And then he has, obviously, his AEM boost gauges. This one's the air fuel ratio, which the air fuel ratio should be around 14.
Yeah.
14 and a half, 13, right?
13, 14.
Yeah, that should be like the proper air fuel ratio. And right now it's like 14.7. So it's close to normal. One thing I did notice about this transmission is the gear ratio is really, really close. So normally for 5 speeds, when you're on the freeway, it averages out to like 3,500 when you're going like 80 miles an hour. So obviously that's really high RPMs, and that's why they kept going with 6-speed, 7-speed. So it's better for fuel economy and the engine life. But with this one, it's still fucking really close. It's close to 3,000 when you're barely going like 65.
Yeah.
So that's pretty crazy about this one too. So what was the difference between the 5-speed and the 6-speed on the freeway? Is it a big difference?
Oh yeah, major. All the gears are like probably 1,500 RPM shorter. So you gotta shift a lot. And then,
What do you think the RPM was in a 5-speed?
What do you mean?
Like at 80.
At 80? Oh, around 80, it would be at like 32.
32? Okay, so it has a little bit of difference.
Yeah. This one will be in 6, and I'll be at 80, and it's at like 35, 36.
So it's even higher in this one.
Yeah.
That's fucking crazy for being, because normally the 6th gear or the 5th gear is always the overdrive gear.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, when you're going on the highway and stuff. So normally 5th and 6th or 4th and 5th are pretty close. It's just a little longer, so that's just fucking crazy how it's even higher than the 5-speed one.
Exactly, yeah. I'm not too big of a fan of that, but...
Dude, who cares, dude?
I got a 6-speed, so that's a Maddie.
Stadium as fuck. So, you bought the JDM transmission with the Stage 2.
Yeah, I put the Stage 2 clutch and everything.
So you put it in there?
Yeah, I changed out my old clutch because that old clutch doesn't work with the 6-speed.
And what brand is the clutch?
This one's an AEM Stage 2.
Okay. AEM?
Yeah.
That's fucking dope. It feels really good. It's
solid.
It's fucking hard to get used to. So I remember Migs posted a picture of his Brembo brakes on Instagram. And I asked him whether they're 350 brakes, but because they look identical to the 350Z and the G35 Brembo package brakes, but they're actually from a JDM STI, which is fucking crazy because, like, literally they're the same color and everything.
Yeah.
Like, they're identical.
They look exactly the same.
Which is fucking crazy, but it stops really good. We're gonna do a brake check right now. Ready? Brakes work. Okay, so this car rides really good, so I want you to give me a rundown of your suspension.
So I have Raceline coilovers. I went the cheap route, but they got full dampening adjustments, so they're not bad. I have no complaints about them.
Cheap coilovers for life, eBay.
Good job, Raceline. I have front and rear sway bars.
What size on the front?
I'm not sure.
I forget all the time in mind. I have to look it up.
Yeah.
It drives really smooth. And I think this is the first all-wheel drive car that, like, I'm actually doing, you know, pulls on. So give a full rundown of your cosmetic ones.
Cosmetic? I have the STI, 05 STI wheels. Uh-huh. I have some adapters on there because mine are 5x100 hubs. I just put that light bar on yesterday. JDM fog lights, JDM headlights, a diffuser that I got from some guy on Instagram. I don't even know who made it. Blast pipes. It's 3-inch all the way through. I have a cat and that's it. I paint matched the side skirts, put some extensions. I think that's it.
You had Yankees.
Yeah, RPF I used to have RPF1s with an even beefier setup.
They looked so nice, bro.
They looked so good, but the Brembos wouldn't clear. So I ran those for about 3 months with brand new tires and everything, and then I had to get rid of them, and I got these STI wheels because...
They look really good, though.
Yeah, I like how simple it looks now, but I really miss those RPF1s. They look mean, but...
Yeah, I mean, that's one thing you guys gotta look into if you're ever doing a big brake kit. You need to look at wheels and see if your wheels fit and clear, because like everything comes into consideration when it comes to that.
Yeah, the 17x8s cleared, but I had the 17x9s and those don't clear. Just because it has a little bit of a lip.
It was probably the offset then.
Yeah,
the offset was still more heavy.
No, it was plus 45 still, but the 17x9s have like a lip.
Okay.
And they have thick spokes, so it pushed up against the Brembos.
That's crazy.
even with like 25 mils, it still wouldn't clear the fronts.
If you guys remember who Eden is, he's in love with this car and he's in love with Migs. So he's probably watching this being jealous AF.
Definitely.
Hi, Eden.
So Migs is actually part of Team Static, so he's gonna be coming over and installing parts whenever he wants to. So we'll be doing more clips of his car, and he's thinking about starting a YouTube channel. So if he does, we'll link it somewhere so you can go and check it out and subscribe. And yeah.
Let me know if you think I should, because I'm on the edge. I'm on the edge of it.
Bro,
if people actually want to see my car, then
you have to have the grind for it though, you know what I mean?
True.
So this is gonna be it for today's review. Thank you, Migs, for letting me drive your dope-ass car. And if you guys want to see any more reviews of any other cars, comment down below. I'll try to find them locally. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, subscribe, share, and we'll see you guys on the next one.